What is wrong with our community? You are creating more drama than a middle schooler, targeting other parents because they have different points of view.
A Rockwood school board member tonight firing off at the community for the harassing and, in his words, bullying by parents over talks of requiring masks. Tonight, the Rockwood board meeting at Marquette, many showed up to vent about not wanting masks when classes begin August 23rd. Well, tonight, News 4's Kim St. Ange is covering the story of parents pulling their kids from school. And Kim, masks are one reason, but so are virtual learning issues.
There's a number of reasons, Sam. So right now I'm at Mason Elementary School in South City. The students here will be starting back up on August 23rd, but some of these kids across these districts in St. Louis will not be returning to the classroom this fall, at least not the typical classroom they were used to. I talked to a St. Charles County parent tonight, and she's pulling her daughter from her actual elementary school after she says she was kicked out because she was not wearing her mask properly.
I just got a call that said, no, she won't wear her mask correctly. You have to leave the school district. You can do the virtual, or you just have to find another place to go.
Michael Wen says her daughter tried virtual for a semester. Despite being a straight A honor roll student, she was falling behind. For this fall semester, Wentz is moving her daughter from the Wentzville School District, where right now masks are optional, to a private school with no mask mandate.
We're not just hedging our bet. We're just saying, no, we're going somewhere that we know we're going to get the education that we need.
She's among many parents choosing to switch schools. According to census.gov, between April and May of 2020, 5.4% of parents across the country reported homeschooling. Just months later, between September and October, that number grew to 11.1%.
I'm not surprised that the numbers shifted.
Dr. Gary Ritter is the dean of SLU University's School of Education. He says in Missouri and Illinois, there's not much you need to do if you decide to homeschool your child. No state agency is in charge of regulating.
There are not checks to ensure that students have gotten the curriculum that they're supposed to have gotten. And I'm not arguing that in a good way or a bad way. I'm saying there are not checks. Students do not have to take assessments or be tested.
Ritter believes there will be a shift back to public schools, possibly in the next year. Wentz has no immediate plans of going back and knows other parents following suit.
A lot of the same people that I've been in contact with in the district, you know, they've done the same thing because they just, you know, weren't going to have their kids masked.
So I checked enrollment numbers tonight at some of the districts across the area, the public school districts. So Kirkwood is telling me its enrollment numbers for this fall are up. Parkway right now is slightly down, though officials do believe that number will increase by the first day of school, which is in just a couple of weeks. And then Melville, which is in South St. Louis County, well, those numbers are also slightly up this fall. Live in South City, Kim St. Ange, News 4.